Okay. Well, first off, let's face it. There was another violent attack last week in baseball by a fan. Now, see this kind of nonsense that goes on? All right, look. I hope it's up there because I don't see anything. But what do you think about this madness?
I think it's your people, Irish people. That's all it is. Drunk Irish people. That still wasn't the way it's supposed to be dealt with. Irish people going, just look in the camera and tell them to stop. You'll end it right now. That's your folks. Drunk, they always got their shirts off when they're in shape. What?
I'll tell them to at least keep their shirts on.
I think it's great. I think it's great. Baseball's boring. Never been a contact sport. You finally get a couple of drunks every couple of innings. Tackle an umpire. I thought it was hilarious.
But they never can fight. At least give me a good fight.
That's the best part of it. You couldn't even run. You saw him. He was going sideways.
You know, the reality is some of these umps do suck.
Yes.
And maybe this will just keep them on their toes a little bit, you know?
I just say, better these guys there than in a comedy club. You know, I deal with them, they don't even know where they are. And you get them out there where they can run around and have some, you know.
Yeah, but none of them know how to fight.
They
can't
fight. It's the damn, Irish people, I'm going to stay on them, man. They cannot fight. Stop it.
Why do you get to be racist?
Because I can. They all fight like this. This is Irish guy.
You know, he raises, you make a point that we can't deny. Look, Irish people can fight. Billy Kahn. It was a few years ago.
That was 1930.
But how drunk
he was good.
How drunk do you have to be, two weeks into the season or 3 weeks, and you're already psychotic? You know, your team's record is 7-5. Well, what difference does it make?
You got money on it.
But it's because a lot of these people, I hate to be on a sophisticated level of psychology that I am, but a lot of these people, they watch the ref blow a call and they get mad because they're drunk and all the blown calls they've made in their lives. You know, the fact that they could have invested in Pfizer and when Viagra came out, the fact the relationship they made.
Carl, it was the first inning. It wasn't nothing even going on.
What was it?
And he attacked a big Dominican Marine.
Dominican? No. It was a Dominican Marine.
Yeah.
Both incidents were at the same ballpark, though, right?
Yeah.
So I don't like how they're making it like it's the whole league. It isn't. It's just
it is.
People on the south side of Chicago.
But don't you think that... That's a good point.
It is.
They won't bring that up.
Yeah. It's
part of our culture now where everybody wants to be, you know, nobody's happy just sitting back and watching anymore. You got to be involved. It's all that reality show. You know, these are people, they're too stupid for a game show, they're too chicken for Fear Factor, they're too ugly to get on Survivor, so they just run out and make fools of themselves on television.
But wait a minute. No. Survivor has some good-looking people, by the way.
But listen, what I'm saying.
You're right. I'm really an idiot. But listen to this. Don't you think, when you look at, like, any other place, their fans go out and, like, you go to England, the soccer fans, like, kick you to death while they're playing, singing the best hits of Ministry and stuff. You know, any other place, people are psychotic. All fans are pretty well-behaved. Just once in a while, it's a drunken person of Celtic extraction.
Well, in Philadelphia.
A Celtic American. Now, let's talk about this.